car, it's like being in the middle of the ocean on a little island, and it can sink at any time. Mm-hmm. He can't find Viv in Ethiopia, and he can't find Molly and Sheba. But they go off to Germany for some reason, because he thinks Viv may be there.
Right.
And of course she isn't.
Right. And then he comes to believe he's made a terrible mistake,
yeah,
and never should have left London. It was important that this character find himself in a situation where he is stripped of everything he values,
yeah,
so that he can, you know, he can begin to understand why he values those things, and why those things are more important than, you know, whether he's going to, for instance, keep the house.
Yeah. Of course, the ending is what will happen to Zan's family.
Right. Right.
The options are in the reader's head.
Right. And I, you know, the there's, I wanted to make a point, particularly in the final paragraph of mm-hmm. the book, which I won't say too much about. You know, I wanted to make a point about what it means to be of this country, about how being of this country is not a matter of where you're born, but of what you believe. It seemed an important point to be making at this time with what has been going on in the country, mm-hmm. and I actually found myself feeling relatively hopeful about this family, yeah, even as they have lost so much.
Yeah. Interesting too, the concept of connecting it to 20 years before and Bobby Kennedy.
Yeah, 40 years. Yeah.
40 years. How fast they fly.
I know.
Yeah. And Jasmine, who ends up being Molly's mother and her connection with Robert Kennedy. And it's interesting again how you as the writer, you don't put it out there. You have to suddenly realize that's who she's talking
mm-hmm,
about.
Mm-hmm, right. You know, I, a book is defined as much by what you leave out,
yeah,
as what you put in. And sometimes the things you leave out are, I think, the things that haunt the reader later on all mm-hmm. the more, because the reader has come to those discoveries him or herself, rather than, as you say, have everything presented.
Mm-hmm.
And also, you know, in the case of Robert Kennedy, you know, I wanted him introduced not as Robert Kennedy.
Yeah.
I wanted him introduced as a guy that we first meet in a pub.
Yeah.
And he becomes defined by the things we come to know about this character,
mm-hmm.
only to then realize who the character is.
Yeah. Have you lived in London?
I can't say that I've lived in London. I've spent some time in London, and I've lived in Europe. I lived in Europe in my 20s,
mm-hmm.
and was in and out of London a lot.
Yeah.
And I've saw London, you know, I've seen London over various periods of time, when the city was quite different from time to time.
Yeah. Where else did you live in London, in Europe?
I lived mainly in Paris.
Mm-hmm.
When it would get too cold to stay in Paris, because I'm born and raised in LA, I would head down to Italy.
Yeah.
So I lived in Italy for a while. I lived for a little while in Amsterdam.
Yeah. Amsterdam, interesting.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I loved Amsterdam, actually.
Yeah.
It would be a great place to live.
Are you writing another novel after this?
I don't even have a gleam in my eye at this point. But I've written enough of them that I trust the gleam will come when it.
Yeah.
When
so
it's
you're
time.
Not having postpartum blues though.
Oh, I do. No,
you
I
do.
Yeah, yes, absolutely. When I go through that after after finishing every novel, publication is always a traumatic experience.
Yeah.
And you know, it's I was talking with my wife just last night that it's not like when a movie is released or a record is released, and there often is some kind of immediate response. You know, mm-hmm. You get a sense right away of how people are responding to it. And a novel is different. It has to kind of make its way out into the world.
Yeah. When you are writing, do you plot?
Do I write an outline?
Yeah.
No, I don't.
No. But before you got into writing the first line, you know where you're going to go?
I know generally where I'm going to go. I know enough to, I think I've learned it can be a mistake to start a novel too soon. Not only in the sense of not knowing where you're going to go, but not having that kind of psychic wind at your back that you need to have to get through the writing of a novel.
Mm-hmm.
So, I have the general configuration in my head, and I know how it's going to start. I have a sense of where I'm going to end up. I don't like to figure out too much more than that. I kind of want to. I want to have a sense of discovery, mm-hmm. along with the reader.
Had you gone to Africa or Ethiopia to adopt your daughter?
I did not go. I stayed with our son, who was at that time fairly small, while my wife went.
Why Africa?
My wife actually had some ties to Africa. She spent part of her childhood in Africa, and she's been back. She's been back since. So she has an emotional bond with Africa.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the searching for the mother—that's literary license.
Yes and no. I mean, we actually found our daughter's birth mother.
Yeah.
But that didn't happen until after I had finished the novel.
Really? Yeah.
So the part of that, there are again, without getting too much into the what's real and what's not,
yeah.
there are elements of that story, including hiring the detective to go find her, that are true.
Yeah. How do you answer a critic who would say this really should be nonfiction because he's using actual thing instead of the fiction part?
Well, in this case, I would say it's almost all fictionalized, at least a little bit.
Yeah.
I have a family of four people, much like the family mm-hmm. in this book. And the family provides a model for the family in this
yeah.
book. But once you start to make choices about what you're going to extract and what you're going to leave behind from the people who are the models,
yeah.
the characters begin to change. And
yeah.
by halfway through this book, for instance, the people in there didn't look quite like the people that I know back home. Zan didn't look especially like me. Parker started to look like himself. The characters take on their own lives,
yeah.
You hope, if the novel's any good. And
yeah.
And they become true unto themselves rather than simply, you know, caricatures of real people. So again, to get back to what I said before, I think some kind of transformation has to take place. I wasn't writing a memoir.
Yeah.
There is a lot of literary license, and I made use of it.
I have to say there was one, I loved one line where I think it was Viv says to her friend James, but I haven't asked you about you.
Mm-hmm.
And it was that, I'm really not interested.
Well, I mean,
in fairness to
Viv, she's kind of overwhelmed at that point.
Yeah.
She's had a traumatic experience getting back from Africa. There was
yeah.
a point where she's stranded in Paris for
and no money.
For a few days with no money. She doesn't know where her husband is or
yeah.
where her children are. So I actually thought it was it showed a certain emotional presence of mind that she realized at some point this person she had had a relationship with once before has something going on in his own life that she hasn't asked about.
Yeah, because again, anybody who wants to know a horror or a nightmare, it is to be in a foreign country and running out of money and not enough to even get the ticket to get back to London.
Exactly.
I mean, and when she is arrested, and they're very nice to her.
Yeah.
Whom can I call?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, she tries to call. She tries to call her husband, but as we've already learned earlier in the book, his cell phone is no longer operative.
Yeah.
And James is the only other person she can think of.
Is there a film script that goes with this?
You mean have I written a film script?
Yeah.
No.
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 Yeah. Because it's a lot of filmic qualities in this book.
Mm-hmm. Well, I will cop to the fact that I've probably been almost as influenced by film as by literature. I was a film student actually, film has made an impact on on my imagination.
Yeah. But you've made a full book, and I thank you, Steve.
Well,
Will you autograph my book?
I would be happy to.
Thank you. And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.ConnieMartinson.com. You can read our columns from the Beverly Hills Courier, but you should also go to your local library. Take a child with you. This is the best, really, deal in America, public libraries. And that child will never forget you when you get them their card. But truly, the books on film, the books on literature, they're there in your library. Even if you like an e-book, there's nothing like holding that book in your hands. And that first walk through the library door and the fact of really, there is a perfume. And support it. And we'll see you next time. Thank you very much, Steve.
Thank you, Connie. Thank you very much.